your asses on around, you go out and you buy a can of or a bottle of nail polish remover, dump out the nail polish remover, and fill it with acetone. Because I don't know what else there is in nail polish remover. What I do know is for pellets for to everything. So this is a way to know if you're acetone around. Put it in your ice chest in the back of your head and prepare it. Is that, first of all, you go in fat, dumb, and happy. You think that you can regulate the vertical action, you know, file the hands, you can reverse the feeds, set everything upright. So now you reduce the size of the hammer. Lock up the action, the hammer rail, take up the lost motion, and now what happens? Squeeze the hammer's wrong way. Because you tip the weapon back. And then I had to do this three or four times before I finally figured out that when you go in to re-regulate a vertical action, you've got to figure that even though the dampers, the spoons were in the right place when you started, once you reduce the size of the hammer, lock up the action rail to take up, to get the correct blow distance, and now you take up a lost motion, you tip the whipple, and you tip that spoon.
The catcher is pretty easy. This is hot water and a wallpaper remover.
Oh.
Yeah. It's a soap solution. You know, approximately 10 parts water, 1 part wallpaper remover. You know, it might be 10 or 15. I mean, it's, if it foams up out of the bottle, then you've got too much wallpaper remover. The wallpaper remover is a surfactant. It makes water wetter. It makes it soak in. So you mix it up, you take it into your house, you throw it in the microwave, give it a zap for about 20 seconds, and it will soften the glue. On the catcher leather, on the butt leather product, you need to be a little judicious on how you apply it, because you're trying to not soak the underpelt. But you just let that work.
When you're replacing just elbows, you can go in with a baby vice grip and clamp on top of the old elbow and then make yourself a really high-tech, sophisticated tool, which is a piece of wood with a slot cut in it. Chop that up in the drill and turn the elbow off. So I'm clamping a vice grip onto the wire right at the top of the old elbow, turning it off or crunching it off with the lever laws or heating it up with a heat gun and hoping that it disintegrates. And then I'm using this to turn, and I'll send this around for what it's worth, it's a piece of wood. You're turning off the old one, you're turning on the new one. You're clamping the vice grips or clamping up the wire in a vice.